Hi, Basak.
Hi, Liz.
You focus on emerging markets for Goldman Sachs Asset Management. Let's talk about the recent market rally around emerging markets equities. What's on the minds of investors right now?
I think there were three main reasons behind the rally that we saw. First of all, lockdowns were coming to an end in Asia especially, so life was normalizing more or less. We cannot say this for all the emerging markets, but certainly things are much better than how they were back in March. Secondly, we've seen very, very strong fiscal stimulus for these countries coming from the governments across different sectors. This also helped to a great extent. And third, and very, very important, we've seen strong corporate earnings. The earnings have been very, very resilient in many of the sectors, and that's also helped support the valuations.
And what sectors are you seeing the strongest performance?
Actually, there were many structural growth stories before the pandemic began, and we only saw an increase in momentum of these growth stories. One would be e-commerce and anything related to online. Online penetration was already growing nicely before the pandemic, and in the environment that we are in right now, actually, that the momentum just took off. For example, online penetration in Latin America is only 5% right now. This compares to 15% in the US and 20% in China. And in the last two quarters, we've seen a very, very fast growth in e-commerce and online penetration in Latin America. So we think that we could see 5% to grow to 10% or 15% in the next 5 years.
Emerging markets are a pretty disparate group of countries across the world. How are you seeing these trends play out across different regions?
It is certainly a very diverse universe. We have more than 25 countries across several different time zones. And these countries have very, very different political systems, economic models, and very different histories. We have, on the one hand, we have China, which is a very big command economy. On the other hand, we have India, which is the largest democracy in the world with 1.3 billion people. Then we have Czech Republic, which is a very small and open economy with only 11 million people. And then we have Chile, which actually resembles a developed market when you look at many different criteria. So among all of these, I would say there are different pockets of growth, there are different consumers, and there are different trends. And I would certainly not call for one single emerging market middle class, but certainly nearly all of these consumers are presenting different growth opportunities.
Basak, one of the things revealed in the pandemic is the dependence of the global supply chain on China. How do you think that might change?
Global supply chains were already being questioned even before the pandemic due to ongoing trade issues between China and the US. And we were seeing some relocation out of China into some other countries. However, this will be much easier for some sectors and it will be a lot more difficult for other sectors. And most of the relocation is actually happening within emerging markets. So the capacity that is going out of China is going to other emerging market countries. And if you look back in the last 2 years, Mexico, for example, has been one of the main beneficiaries of some of the capacity coming from China into Mexico.
And what about fintech, which is an area where there's been a lot of activity in emerging markets?
Fintech and payments actually are sectors where emerging market countries and companies have a definite lead. And most of the developed market companies and countries are looking at examples in emerging markets world to understand the addressable market and how their companies and countries will look 5 years, 10 years down the line.
And where are you seeing the most activity around fintech?
China and India are definitely way ahead of many other countries in terms of the companies and number of users and growth projections. However, other countries and regions are also catching up very, very fast. Latin America, for example, right now is doing very well on the payments and fintech front. It's great to see so many companies doing so well, not only because of corporate earnings, but it's actually because fintech is a great way to improve financial intermediation. in those countries, we have many unbanked and underbanked people, and providing financial intermediation to these people is going to be the first step to pull them out of poverty and bring them into the financial system.
So Basak, what will you be watching in the emerging markets in the months ahead?
As fundamental investors, we always focus on the earnings growth. Actually, if you look at history, more than 85% of the stock price performance can be explained by earnings. This year, clearly, earnings will be down quite significantly. And then next year, we are going to see a very, very nice recovery. But I think both of them are less meaningful given the big swings. But if you look at last year's earnings and compare them to 2021 earnings and then average it out, we see about 7-8% earnings growth coming from emerging markets in dollar terms, which I think is quite respectable given the growth backdrop. So I think that's a good result considering everything. And emerging markets continue to trade at a significant discount to developed markets. So there is discount to historical levels, there is discount to developed markets, and we also have, you know, nice earnings growth. So all in all, I am positive for emerging markets, and the companies that we invest certainly will show earnings growth much better than those 7-8% average levels.
Thanks, Basak.
Thank you very much.